Okay, let's take a look at some laptop slash utility shelves. This was the first one I made. It's a prototype. It's just cutting boards, paracord, and I just glued some hard drive magnets to the back. Sprayed a little spray electric tape just for some friction so it wouldn't slide. And that one's worked out really well for me. I like it. A few co-workers wanted some, so I tried some different designs. The problem I saw with this is when I put a laptop up here, sometimes the cables rub over here depending on the size of the laptop. So on this next version, we just cut that out so it's not there. We tried some cup magnets. We used some 16 pounds. That electric tape's there just for friction. But the 16 pounds weren't enough, so we had to double them up. They felt like they were going to be when we stuck them to the metal, but what we found is when you push down, it kind of pries that corner. And once that corner pries off, the magnet comes off pretty easily. These aren't really required for any strength. All the leverage pulling down's up here. So we added a couple hard drive magnets. So that was the second one we did. This is the third one we made. We tried larger magnets on this one. They're still ceramics. But we ran into the same problem that it wants to pry away from here. And then once it pries a little bit, it'll pull that magnet off. So we just added a couple neodymium square magnets that took care of that problem. And then we determined we would go ahead and try a much stronger magnet. So on this one we used neodymium magnets, but that magnet's so strong you can barely get it off. So what we ended up doing is putting the weaker ceramics at the bottom, and that makes it pretty easy just to pry it from the bottom, and then you have levers to get it off from the top. If you were to try to pull it from here, it's not coming off. And then we changed to a jacketed cable, the thinnest cable I could find. And then we also, to alleviate that problem we have up here of it prying the corner, we dropped it down a little bit. So if we pull on here, it can flex a little bit in here, but really not much. So, and then the cable we just, you can kind of see right in the side of it. We just drilled. The lighting's bad. We just drilled through it, bent the cable over, and glued it in. So that ended up being a pretty strong connection. The first version, I just tied a knot with the paracord. The next ones, I just melted the paracord. That's still pretty strong. It's just strong enough to hold any laptop or anything like that. Same thing here, we just melted the paracord. And then this was the fourth one, and then this was the last one. I changed the magnets on this one. I did something a little different. We put bar magnets on. So we put some bar magnets on. We threw a little bit of tape just for friction again, because that metal slides. But that way it's a little bit wider. It's not quite as strong as the neodymium cup magnet, and it's wider. So that's really what I wanted. And again, the weaker ceramics down here, so you could pry it off from the bottom pretty easily. And then again, you know, that tape's just for friction. A little bit of tape right here for friction. So if I move this, and then the cable, different. We just tried some different hinges. I like these bigger ones a little bit better. Those. But those will work as well. And then the cable again. What we did was we kind of bent that cable. That way when we close it. And you have to add a magnet here and here. This one I tried magnets on the two ends. That didn't work out very well at all. I don't like that. So we went back to the center magnet. So this last one I did, I actually liked the best. So I'll probably make one more of these for myself in red. That original prototype's the first one. I'll make another one of these with the bar magnets We moved them in a little bit in case I'm on a more narrow. I've been on an elevator controller that was kind of narrow, and these wide magnets didn't work very well. And then you see if I push down really hard, there's a little bit of flex here. But I mean, I can put some pretty heavy stuff. I can put some pretty heavy stuff on there, and it's gonna work just fine. So whether it's a laptop, just a little book, whatever. The main feature with these is they will fit in a laptop case. I needed them to be small and light. If I wanted, I could take the time to drill some more holes to lighten it, but it doesn't lighten it enough to really justify the effort, to be real honest. So, but yeah, I like this one the best. Because my ceramics are up a little higher, there's some flex at the bottom. So what we did is we added just a little spacer with some hot melt glue gun. That way, there's not any flex. If you look right there, it's going to be almost impossible with this. But if you look right there, you'll see it doesn't flex. Or you just have to take my word for it if you can't see it. That comes off pretty easy, but these magnets are strong. The problem is you can't hardly find neodymiums weak enough for what you want, but then the ceramics that are strong enough are just way too big and heavy. So these ceramics might possibly work if we would have lowered this down. It's just kind of trial and error. So